गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ब्रिलियंट पब्लिक स्कूल. द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन इज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स फॉर क्लास 11th. फॉर दैट फर्स्ट लेट अस रिकैपिचुलेट व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोसीड विद दिस चैप्टर. एज यू ऑल नो, स्टैटिस्टिक्स डील्स विद डेटा कलेक्टेड फॉर अ स्पेसिफिक पर्पस. Measures or central tendency are the representative values. You already have studied this. The measures of central tendency, namely mean, mode and median, gives us the rough idea where the data point are centered. Let us recall how to find the mean. You all know very well that mean of group data can be found by method direct method, where we take the multiplication of the mid value and the frequencies upon the total number of frequencies there. And in assume mean method, we assume a mean, that is a provisional mean, and using the given formula we find the mean. This already you have studied in your 10th class. Now, in order to make better interpretations from the data, we should have an idea how the data are scattered or how much they are bunched around the measure of central tendency. Many a times we see that measures of central tendency are not sufficient to give complete information about given data because of variability. We need to have a single number to describe this variability. Now, this single number to describe variability is called as measure of dispersion. In this class we are going to study measure of dispersion. Following are the measures of dispersion: range, quartile deviation, mean deviation and standard deviation. So we are going to study mean deviation in detail in this class. Now, mean deviation about the mean, it means clearly how much the data is scattered, what is the deviation. So let us discuss how to find mean deviation about the mean in case of ungrouped data. You know children, we have grouped as well as ungrouped data. So we are going to find out the mean deviation about the ungrouped data. And then in grouped data also you have two different cases, that is discrete frequency and continuous frequency. Now, in case of ungrouped data, mean deviation is given by, if we consider n observations x1, x2 till xn, the mean deviation about their mean. So it is very clear from the formula that first you need to find the mean. After finding mean, that is x bar, by the concept studied in earlier class, we use the formula mean deviation about the mean is summation of mod of xi minus x bar upon n, that is total number of frequencies. So it is very clear from mod of xi minus x bar, we are finding that how much the entries are deviating from the mid value. Next, if it is the case of discrete frequency, you know that we consider the observations x1, x2, xn till xn occurring with frequencies. We have some number of frequencies for this particular entries, that is f1, f2 and fn respectively. So the same change in the formula, mean deviation about the mean, in case of discrete frequency, it will be summation of fi into mod of xi minus x bar upon summation of fi, that is n. Hope it is clear, children. Next, if it is continuous frequency, what is the only thing, children? In this case, you are going to find the mean with the help of any of the method which you have learned depending upon the data, maybe direct method or assume mean method or step deviation method. After finding the mean by any of this method in case of continuous frequency, you are going to use the same formula to find the mean deviation in this case. Now, as we have discussed mean deviation about the mean, now we will discuss mean deviation about the median. Now for that, of course, I need to know that how to find the median. So let us recall the methods of finding the median which we have already studied in earlier classes in case of grouped and ungrouped data. So from the formula, it's very clear, children. You could see here, median of continuous series n by 2th term if the number of terms are odd, and then if the number of terms are even, you know it very well, n by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term upon 2. We take the average of those two. And in 10th class, you have learned that the median of group data can be found using the formula L plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into H. Let us again recall, L is the lower limit of the median class, n number of observations, CF is cumulative frequency of class interval preceding the median class, F is frequency of the median class, and H is the class size. So using these, we can very easily find the median of the grouped data. Now let us discuss how to find mean deviation about the median in group data. So it would be same, children. First of all, I need to find the median as I have found mean in the earlier case. So you could see, what is the change in the formula? In place of xi minus x bar, now I have xi minus m, where I am going to find the deviations from the median. So it is very clear. So we find median and then we use the similar formula there. Now in the same case, children, if I go ahead in case of group data, you could see again the same formula, summation of fi into mod of xi minus m. In place of x bar, it's m, because our target is to find mean deviation about the median. Now, in case of continuous frequency, you know very well what is to be done. Now, next thing is variance. Now, there was a thing that why we are taking mod, that is the absolute values, that is all positive entries. So it was thought that if we take square of that deviation, you know very well, square of positive as well as negative term is positive itself. So mean of squares of the deviation from mean is called as its variance. So first of all, I find mean x bar, and then variance, which is denoted by sigma square, is given by summation of xi minus x bar whole square upon n. Very clearly you can see, children, instead of mod of xi minus x bar, I have taken xi minus x bar whole square here. So instead of taking absolute values, we are squaring the equation here in this case to find the variance, that how much the data is varied. Now, one of the measure of dispersion, that is standard deviation, it is nothing but the square root of the variance. Just in the previous slide, we have seen that sigma square is the variance. I just take the square root of that and I will be getting the standard deviation of the data. Now, if it is continuous frequency distribution, children, again the same thing. If you remember step deviation method, we are going to change this xi as xi minus a upon h. That is nothing but the step deviation method we have used earlier. So this formula is also called as shortcut formula, because it reduces the calculations and you are very easily able to read the result. Now, if I have two datas, that how much they are varying. So it is nothing but to compare two or more frequency distributions, we compare their coefficients of variation. So the coefficient of variation is defined as standard deviation upon mean into 100. So this coefficient of variation tells us that what is the variability of the data. Now, the important thing to note is that the distribution having a greater coefficient of variation has more variability around the central value than the distribution having a smaller value of the coefficient of variation. Hope you understood, children. So let us revise what all things we have discussed, which all concepts we have touched in this particular module. So we have revised what is mean and median. Next, new concept, that is measure of dispersion, how much the data is deviated or dispersed or scattered. Then mean deviation about the mean, mean deviation about the median. Then we have discussed about variance and standard deviation. Hope all the concepts are clear after seeing these slides. And the last one was coefficient of variation. So keep learning, children. After understanding these concepts, practice all the questions from NCERT using the learned concept. Thank you, everyone, and have a nice day.